This week on Maker Update, the Pirates of Western New York, a Starship control panel for your computer, shooting bees, and an easy mode for pyrotechnics. Ahoy, sea dogs, and welcome back to Maker Update. I'm Tyler Weingarter, and I hope you're all doing great and staying inspired. We've got a pretty awesome show in store for you, so let's not waste any time getting to the project of the week. This weekend, I got to see this fantastic pirate-themed house haunt created by Tony DeMatteo at his home in Churchville, New York. Tony sets up this yard-spanning display in front of his house every Halloween, and it culminates in a series of 45-minute long shows with music, cued lights, animatronics, simulated cannon fire, and pyrotechnics. It's tough to know where to begin with this one. It's just that big. The pirate ship itself and the shipwreck are basically constructed like stage props. There are a couple of sturdy load-bearing platforms, but it's mostly a facade of barn wood. This castle set is made from insulation foam and framed by 2x4s. The cannons fire by way of a pretty neat trick. Fog machines fill up this entire manifold with fog, and when the cannons fire, a solenoid valve releases forced air from an air compressor down the barrel of the cannon, creating a pretty convincing cannon fire when combined with lights and sound effects. They're completely harmless, which is good considering they're facing towards the crowd. Speaking of lights, the entire set is covered with banks of RGB spotlights that can light up in any color depending on the current mood of the show. This skeletal pirate captain looks menacing enough, but he's just a simple animatronic controlled through an armature and what looks like a windshield wiper motor. The cannons, lights, pyrotechnics, and everything else are all controlled via DMX through a piece of software running on his computer called Showtime by Lightorama. With the crowds this display draws, it really turns into a whole neighborhood affair. The good news is that it also works as a fundraiser for the Dream Factory of Rochester, which is a charity that grants wishes for critically and chronically ill children. The show I got to see is the last one of the year, so if you missed it, you missed it. But if you're in the Western New York area, check out his website and see what else Tony is up to. And while you're there, you can also learn more about this display and see plenty of behind-the-scenes footage of how some of the props were made. More projects. A few weeks ago, I got to finally release a project I worked on over the summer. A programmable Macropad for your computer designed after one of the control panels for the Artemis, the ship featured in The Expanse, a Telltale series. The Expanse is one of my favorite science fiction stories, so I was really excited to work on this one. The Macropad features 8 programmable mechanical key switches. These 2 toggle switches for changing key mappings, and some rotary knobs for additional functions. The key switch interface is made from this 5x6 snap-apart key switch matrix by Adafruit, which is a really fun and easy way to make custom key interfaces. The brains of this is the Feather RP2040, and it's all coded in CircuitPython for easy programming. It was also my first full project in CircuitPython. If you're interested in building your own, check out the link in the description for code, 3D printing files, a BOM, and plenty more. Emily the engineer has built a Wasp gun. You heard that right, a Wasp gun. She wanted a humane way to clear out the wasps on her friend Dan's property. So she figured she would just suck them up using a shop vac cyclone into a mason jar, and then relocate them elsewhere, at high velocity. She originally tried to do this using the Venturi effect, but gave up on that and just used high pressure air to urge them out to their new home. It's a fun video, check it out. And finally, we have this Raspberry Pi AllSky camera by Alaskan Astro. An AllSky camera is kind of what it sounds like. It captures a 180-degree dome view of the entire sky. Because this is in Alaska, it should provide plenty of dramatic views of the stars. But because it's in Alaska, it also has a lot of weather to contend with. Powering the Pi via PoE minimizes the number of cables that need to go into the enclosure. And it exhausts waste heat up towards the dome to keep moisture or frost away from the camera lens. It's a cool project with a lot of interesting considerations. Time for some tips and tools. From chatting with Tony about his Haunted on Ambush project, I learned about these flame effect machines by Ridgeyard. Normally, when I see a triggerable flame effect, I just assume it's a DIY propane poofer. But this is a totally turnkey solution that you can buy on Amazon. They're fueled by cans of starting fluid, and you can program the effects using DMX. Maybe if you do the sort of work that involves flame effects, you already knew about these, but I was really excited to learn about them. Over on Adafruit, I learned about this USB-C PD breakout. PD, or power delivery, is a USB-C protocol that allows you to send up to 20 volts and higher wattages over a USB-C cable. You can select the desired voltage using solder pads, or you can adjust on the fly as needed using I2C, although that's a little trickier since there isn't an onboard voltage regulator. As is typical for Adafruit products, there's a helpful guide on how to use this one. Over on Jeremy Fielding's channel, I found this older video where he's tearing down a commercial printer he found on the side of the road. It's easy to see stuff like this as just junk, but there can easily be a gold mine of future project components hidden in old hardware. Metal shafts, bearings, bushings, stepper motors, solenoids, relays, hinges, you name it. Even the process of taking stuff apart can be relaxing, so it's a good way to de-stress while you're getting project parts for free. For this week's DigiKey Spotlight, they have a new video out in their Another Teaching Moment series about the difference between pressure and force. Pressure and force are closely related concepts that are very similar. Force is a pulling, pushing, or twisting action placed on an object that's free to move. On the other hand, pressure is a measure of force divided by the surface area that it's acting on. It's a good distinction to understand. Check out the video to learn more. All right, and that is going to do it for this week's show. I hope you had a fun Halloween and a fun time with this episode. If you did, give us a thumbs up, leave us a comment, and hit subscribe with the bell so you don't miss the next one. As always, great big thanks to DigiKey for making this whole show possible and you for watching. Take care. We'll see you soon.